Think she didn't get the memo that a dog is a man's best friend.
Elon motherfucking Musk! I just paid an Etsy witch $7.99 to make your life a living hell. Brace yourself.
Y'all are weird. You think I would trust a man enough after everything I've been through to get me pregnant? Bitch, I kill you in your sleep. I kill you in your sleep before. In fact, the minute I find out I'm pregnant, I'm gonna kill you in your sleep, and then I'm gonna go get an abortion. Two people will be dead.
A man talks to me when I'm walking down the street. I'm gonna lose my shit on them. Men are going to live in fear.
Oh, women are so sensitive. Women are so sensitive. Why don't you smile? Why don't you fuck me? Die!
May he do everything he promised you he would. And may you fucking choke on it.
How about my Glock, your dome? Your body, my trunk. Your body in the motherfucking lake. Your body in a body bag. I will perform a late-term abortion on your ass. I will do what your mother should have done 20-some-odd years ago. Don't piss me off today. Don't piss me off ever. Y'all are fucking around with a bunch of pissed-off fucking women right now, and you're about to find out in the worst way possible. Keep making your little jokes.
What y'all, little deuce-deuce, little 22, little double-P shooter? I ain't trying to get no Glocks to the dome, man.
I want to be funny. We're about to be hilarious.
We'll never sleep with a man who voted for Donald Trump. The vote for him is a vote against my rights as a woman to protect myself and make decisions about my body. It means he does not respect me as a woman or think that my life and my choices have value. Women know who you're voting for and know who you're sleeping with.
Hey, MAGA. I was just taking some trash out and I thought I found a flying f- to give for you. You know, about you losing friends and family members this past week due to your cult activity. But it turns out it was just a plain old fuck you.
I hope and pray you have the next 4 years you deserve and you get everything you voted for. And it not only affects you, but also everyone you love. Have the next 4 years you deserve.
Yeah, it seems like some of these males are trying to make up for voting. And, you know, a lot of these women, these are their partners. So I think what they're trying to do is they're just trying to get, you know, they're trying to get their wife back. Some of these men are just trying to get their wife back. They're just trying to come back home. They in the doghouse right now. Trump was president before, and the sky didn't fall. I know that everybody was screaming, the sky's falling, I'm moving out the country, I'm moving to Canada, all of this. Nobody moved. Everybody's still here. Chill, man. Chill. You survived 4 years of it, nothing changed.
Disgustingly alarming number of people voted completely against their moral conscience and chose privilege and white supremacy in the name of the economy, of all things, which many are sadly discovering the truth about that.
Anybody who is on the fence about becoming a lesbian, now is your chance! Like, give it a shot, give it a shot, let's give these f***ing men up! Like, I'm telling you, this shit's greener on the other side, like, come on.
Up the shackles of yesterday, shoulder to shoulder gave freedom away. Our daughters' daughters will abhor us, and they'll sing in dreadful chorus. What have you done, sister suffragette? What have you done, sister suffragette?
It looks like somebody got to put down the sippy cup. You got to put down that sippy cup. There's too much juice in there for you. It's just it's just got you really emotional right now. I mean, hey, was a catchy tune, though. I ain't going to lie. Was a catchy tune. Karaoke night must be great.
I'm trying to decide what to get my Republican-leaning family members for Christmas. and I'm really thinking about a donation in their name to Planned Parenthood. Something that I feel strongly about. They don't, but it's better than getting no gift at all. Have a great day.
Her body, my choice.
Do it. Do it. Do it. Give me a reason. Give me a reason. Do it.
So men think they own you. Take it from somebody that used to be a man. You got boobs. You got a vajayjay. Guess what, honey? You own them. Trust me, they want it. Make them earn it.
I don't know how you can be a woman and support that man because he publicly hates women. You're just saying you have no respect for yourself, is how I'm seeing this. Yeah. So fuck you. And now that he's going to be in office again, he can replace the person that's going to be stepping down with another pro-life asshole that doesn't care about women's health. Yeah. So basically, we are living in The Handmaid's Tale. Yeah. So, fuck all of you guys that are acting like it's not his fault. It is.
Trump won. We are officially about to become second-class citizens. Here's a tip. If you ever encounter a man, this is what you can do. If you're scared, whatever, you don't want them around you, what you're gonna do is bark at them. It draws attention to yourself. They get scared. There's like a look of fear in their eyes. They all get it. And they leave you alone. So yeah, I'm sure we've all tried to be nice and they follow us home and whatever, whatever. No longer being nice, we're barking.
Think she didn't get the memo that a dog is a man's best friend.
I'm just gonna start being so fucking mean to men. Like, not like I wasn't really particularly nice to them before. Because, like, you know.
I just very quickly came on here to say that I'm so excited for and I fully support this movement of making mainly men's lives, but really anyone who voted for Trump's lives miserable. I'm really enjoying all this content about tormenting them. So, keep it up.
How could you not vote for Kamala? I just don't get it. How could you possibly vote for a man, a straight white male, of all people? A straight white male. How could you do that?
Oh, man. The lack of self-awareness in these videos, just they're just funny. I'm sorry. I'm addicted to these videos because to watch people lose it like this, it's just funny. And a lot of these people are sober. I lose it when I have a few. But these guys are just losing it totally sober.
How could you do that to us? How could you do that to yourself? How could you do that to us? Somebody explain. I just don't get it. How could you not vote for Kamala? Make it make sense, people.
I'm making plans. I've got two plans on how I can survive an authoritarian hellscape. I'm focusing on those plans, and I'm kind of getting excited because I'm good with the plan, you know? And I'm implementing my plan. And it's big and it's scary, but, you know, what's the alternative? There's not one, no. Okay, so do your thing, make a plan, start working on your plan, and, build your bubble every day. Keep the losers and the haters out of your bubble because it's your bubble. You get to decide what goes on in your bubble. You can be delusional in your bubble. You can be happy in your bubble. You can be proactive in your bubble. Do whatever you want in your bubble. It is your bubble. It is time to cut the dead weight lies, guys.
All right, Skeeter. It looks like your bubble just burst. It seems like all of y'all bubbles burst over this entire election. It's just, I just can't. I can't. Just go.
I also think we should go do our own January 6th. What do you guys say? Jan 6th? Let's go. Let's stop this dictator. Save America.
Dominic, what do you think I expect you to do if you hear one of your little boy classmates say that to a girl in your school? What do you think I expect you to do? Stick up for them, right? How?
Telling the guy.
No, I want you to ball up your fist and break their shit. Do you understand me? The only person you got to worry about getting in trouble with is me. And you're going to get in way more trouble if you participate in that bullshit than if you punch somebody in the mouth for participating in that bullshit. Do you understand me? Do you understand me?
Punch your eye.
Yeah, punch him in the eye, Kevin. Exactly. Punch him right in the eye. Because punch it is not enough. Listen, it is not enough to just not be asshole boys, right? You have to do things about the other asshole boys. It is your job to stop those boys from being assholes. Got it? That's all. Go finish watching your cartoons.
For everyone that voted for that man, I want nothing to do with you. I'm not going to engage with you. And honestly, like, if you leave comments on my page saying Trump 2024 or whatever, that's fine. Because you're just making it easier for me to figure out who I should be blocking.
I'm just going to...
So you couldn't deliver this message with your jacket zipped up. You had to have it all out there, right? I don't think you are abstaining from any men for the long term. I could say you right now. You're obviously trying to get their attention. That's what you want. You want attention. I get it. I understand.
Say it because I'm tired of hearing people trying to explain away why these poor, disenfranchised young men skewed Republican this election. They like MAGA because they want to go back to the time where they were handed the keys to the castle and a doting wife in exchange for existing. They feel disenfranchised because this is no longer their reality.
I just told a Trumper wearing a Trump shirt in Palm Springs, California at the Trader Joe's, "Fuck you." And I'm insane, apparently. And I was like, yeah, no, you're right. I am fucking crazy. I have lost my mind. What do you want to do about it? You want to find out just how much? So he got out his camera and stood behind my car, and I backed out. And I just thought, you know, if he's going to be stupid enough to stand there, I will hit him because that's how much I don't give fucks right now. He got out of the way. And then came up to my window, and like, I should have just driven off. I didn't. I don't know what I said. I think I blacked out a little bit. I think I was actually working through ripping his face completely off of his stupid fucking head.
Basically what it seems like the only threat here is you guys. I mean, you guys seem very upset and very violent. It's scary. It's scaring me a little bit. That being said, what do you guys think? Put it in the comments. Are any of you guys thinking this way? Do any of you guys have these feelings, these built up fire burning feelings, like you want to throw somebody in the trunk? Because I heard one lady said she was going to put a man in the trunk. She said, mess around and find out. I got the G-lock on. All right. That being said, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to comment, subscribe, thumbs up, and slap that red button.